So today I will read a little from the teachings of Sukadeva Gosvāmī in the beginning. You know, Sukadeva Gosvāmī is the speaker of Bhagavad Gita. Is spoken by Krishna, the Krishna's word. And Bhagavad is spoken by Sukadeva Gosvāmī. He is the son of Vedavyasa. He spoke it to whom? Parikshit Maharaj, grandson of Maharaj. Okay? He spoke this. And even though he is the main speaker of Bhagavatam, there is a description about him in the first chapter. But he comes to speak in the first verse of the second chapter. This arranged. So many things happen in the first chapter. And then the Parikshit Maharaj scene is built, how he is cursed to death and he takes shelter, and there are so many sages sitting. They are figuring out what should be done because he has only 7 days. Some little kind of doubt is there. Always two people will have different opinions. And then suddenly this boy comes. He is a young boy, your age, 18 year old. Maybe you have books of engrossed. 18 year old young boy. And the sages are so old. Vedavyasa is already an old person. His guru is there, Narada there. And many sages are there. Top sages, which we hear in the scriptures, all top personalities. But this boy comes, he's only 18 years old. And he walks to there. He's naked. Actually, his history was that he is the son of Vedavyasa. And till 14 years of his life, he did not come out of the womb of his mother. In fact, Vedavyasa was instructing him in the womb. He was already self-realized. He heard Vedavyasa is the person who has written all the scriptures. And he is teaching his son, obviously. And son is listening. And so he is requesting, father is saying, Beta, please come out now. Papa, no, I don't want to come out. Beta, come out, your mother is suffering. Because imagine a child has grown inside for you. He says, no, I can see how much you are attached to your wife. This world is full of Maya. I don't want to come. So finally, it became so desperate that Krishna went to Vedavyasa, went to Dwarka to meet Krishna. He can get definitely audience from Krishna. He said, this is the problem. And I cannot bring my wife here. You have to come here. So Krishna came all the way to his ashram. And he told the Sukadeva Gosvāmī, please come out. Why you are troubling your wife? He said, my dear Lord, I am worried of illusory energy in this world. Krishna said, I give you guarantee, it will not touch you. And then Krishna entered. Then he took his birth. But the moment he took birth, he did not stay in the house for 1 second. He just ran from the house. And his father was waiting to see him for 14 years. Just imagine. Father, you know, just like similar, wearing dhoti, running behind him. Putra, putra. Sanskrit. The trees were echoing the song. He was just like, no way, I want to be. Then Vedavyasa said, my dear son, I can understand your situation. But I have not finished teaching you. I want to tell about you, about a person who gave moksha to the lady who gave him poison. You know the story of Putana, correct? Putana gave to Krishna poison. She came to poison Krishna and kill him. But Krishna killed her. But at the same time, Krishna felt that I have to kill her because, you know, she is continuously killing children like this. But at the same time, she acted like my mother now. She gave me milk. So that aspect, Krishna rewarded her and liberated her and made her a woman equivalent to Yashoda in Vaikuntha. Eternal situation, he liberated her. So this is very, you know, very, we are also positive, but nobody is positive like. So I want to talk about such a personality. So Sukadeva Gosvāmī said, yes, my father, I want to hear. So he had already told him synopsis of Bhagavatam when he was in the womb. Now he started expanding. And Sukadeva Gosvāmī was a great pleasure hearing the whole Bhagavatam he heard from his father. Now when he came to the end, he was so pure that he was a samadhi on Krishna. for the next 4 years. And he was free from all the social details. He was just walking like that. Air is his address, is the air, naked, walking air. And some, you know, children were, you know, throwing some stones on him or laughing at him, giggling at him. And some girls were also following him. It was a very beautiful morning. So this was the scene. And suddenly, you know, by will of the power, he walked. He's walking where he wants to walk. He used to go to a householder where they are, you know, milking a cow. Previously, so he used to walk to some householder's place, and the fortunate householder used to happily give him a palm full of milk. Ego palm full here, 2 kilos, 50. Body requirement over. And busy thinking about Krishna. And then what happened? That he now walks into this assembly, just looking at him, you know. We can, all the great scenes that we make out. My God, this boy is so young, but he is so unparalleled in his meditation of Krishna. They all get up. That is surprising, you know. Small boy is walking to the big scene and all, Gadi, immediately everybody gets up. And this boy comes to the assembly. And they all make him the chief guest. And they make him seated on a welcome. They make him seated on a seat, and Parikshit Maharaj falls at his feet. He says, I have a question. My question is this. He is sitting at the lotus feet of Sukadeva Gosvāmī. My question is this. What is the duty of a man who is about to die? What is anyway a duty of a general person? What is he supposed to do? Particularly, please tell me, what is the duty of a man about to die? And because he was a great devotee of Krishna, Parikshit Maharaj, because he is trained by Pandavas. Pandavas, you know, Pandavas, no sons were there, everybody had died. This grandson was there. So they trained him, he was a great devotee. He said, what is the duty of a, should I talk about Krishna, think about Krishna or something else? What should I do? So this is the scene actually. Sukadeva Gosvāmī is sitting on an elevated seat, naked. And here he is sitting, he is an emperor, but he is sitting in non-simple dress at his lotus feet. And he has asked a question. Now Sukadeva Gosvāmī begins to speak. First canto ends. If you read first canto of Bhagavatam, you have to read the second canto, because just like moving a hero gave it, it's okay. Like the Sukadeva Gosvāmī gave it. So he appears. And he speaks. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudeva. Let me offer my obeisances to Lord Krishna. Vasudeva means son of Vasudeva. Okay? It has a lot of meaning, but that is one. Śrī Śukadeva
Gosvāmī
Variyānesha Te Prashna Krita Loka Hitam Nripa Ātavitta Sammadha Pumsam Shotavyanishukyapana. Beautiful Shukha. Śrī Śukadeva Gosvāmī. Respectable personality gyāni. Śrī Śukadeva Gosvāmī. Śrī Gosvāmī speaking. This is making sound. Variyāna esha te prashna. Variyāna means glorious. You can see the word meaning is there. Glorious. What is glorious? Your question. Your question is so wonderful. Just like suppose you are, now you have learned, some of you have finished engineering, some new person comes and says, I have a question. What a question. They are saying, Variyānesha Te Prashna. What a question. Generally, people go to sadhu for asking what question? What job I'll get? And how will I get this? How will I get this? He's not asking. Therefore, we should not go to sadhu for the items which are available in the market. This is another domain, spiritual domain. Don't go for health, for some peace of mind. Go with absolute questions. I have a question. So his question was, what is the duty? In fact, Vedic culture is a duty-bound culture. Always person is thinking, what is my duty? You know, recently, one of the top ministers in Japan made a statement. What is the statement? Old people, I request you, please hurry up and die. Can you imagine? How can somebody speak so painful? Hurry up and die. Because in Japan, mein kya ho gaya, the general population now, the old age people are more. It is also affecting their economy. Even China is going to come to the same situation because they force so much one child. The old people are now more than the younger generation. So imagine somebody in our situation. Many times people become blind and they get blind. So anyway, so he is saying, Vari Anna, Isha Deva Shah. What a question it has. Krita Loka Hitam Nidamaha. The answer to this question is going to benefit the whole society. Hitam. Hitam means beneficial. It benefits the whole society. Ārtavit sambandha pumsa. Ārtavit means those who self-realize people. They all agree. Sambandha means they all agree that this is needed. Such kind of questioning and hearing is needed in the society. Now what happens when a person becomes old? Actually, even old people, not only the youngsters sometimes wish old people die. Even the old people wish to die sometimes. They nowadays in Norway country, so many countries, after 70 years, you can go for euthanasia. It is legal. You can kill yourself. And the state will assist you if you are finding it difficult. They will bring in the injection along and they'll help you. Imagine. Your people, because they don't know what's the mission of life. So, therefore it happens. So he is saying now, Śrī Śukadeva is saying, what questions you ask is so beautiful. It is so beneficial for the society. And this is agreed by all the ātma-tattva people, all the advanced spiritualists agree. Śrota vyāri śrīyā parāha. This is the topmost to be here. He's congratulating his disciple. Wow! Kya question pucha tu? Khush ho gaya. Think now let us see what happens. Now, how does it continue? Okay, this shloka I will request. Two, three people can repeat. Shota vyadini rachendra.
Shota vyadini rachendra.
Nam santim sahashrashaha. Apashyatam ātma-tattvam Vriheshu Vriyamenina. Yes, who will repeat this? Anybody can chant this? Tell us. Koshish karo. See, jahan, there is a dash over a vowel, A or I, that becomes dirgha. That's it.
Śrota-vyādini-rācendra
Nidāṁ-santam-sahaśraśaha Apashyatāṁ-ātma-tattvam Vriheshu-kriyamenina. Yes, after so much again. Who wants to go?
Śrota-vyādini-rācendra
pages. So where you can download nowadays, you can take advantage and read So what do you say? Shrotavyadini Rajendra. Shrotavya, my dear king, Raja means king. People have so many subject matters of hearing. How many? Sahasrashaha. Sahasra means thousand. People have thousands of things to hear. That's true or not? Internet of battery matlab uth nahi paate. Udhar bhi dekhte, kya udhar bhi dekhte. They have million things to hear. Apashyatam ātma-tattva. You tell them, books are available. Free it is. You can issue and return. But crore cheez ho sakta hai. Idhar kya hua, udhar kya hua, udhar kya hua. Person can hear million things, but he has at least, let me read two paragraphs in a day. To start, actually everything starts with a vicious cycle, correct? Abhi koi cigarette peeta hai to kya hota hai? Ek se puff se shuru karta hai, dheere dheere addict ho jata hai. So similarly, you need to read one paragraph, then two paragraphs a day. Just read one stroke and the meaning of it. It has enough meaning. This is an apple a day gives a doctor a day, a shloka a day gives maya a day. Just read. That much you meditate, the whole day you just, whenever you get time, you just think about what was it telling actually. So not only just hear, try to think about that subject and try to absorb it. So what is this? People have millions of subject matters of hearing. Why? Apashyata ātma-tattvam. Because they are not able to see. Apashyatam dikhnira, kya? Ātma-tattvam, which is really needed for me. Us cheez ko toh miss kar raha hai. Correct? Apashyata, they don't know. Those persons are mentally engrossed, being blind to the knowledge of health, absolute truth, leave many subject matters of hearing in human society. Abhi, if you go to the market, open a bookshop, wow, karoda cheez hai. Ātma-tattva nahi hai. TV bolo. Karoda chahiye, ātma-tattva bhi nahi milta. Some people try and hardly find any program, even spiritual jo hote, they all talk about mundane welfare. They cannot talk about ātma-tattva, very rare. So either you put up any medium today, it is mostly 99.99999% filled with apashyata ātma-tattva, ātma-tattva ka vaati nahi. How do we eat, how do we sleep like that? Okay, now it continues. This is understood. Just we are see, because what happened, any great personality, when you ask him some question, in just 3-4 verses, actually summarizing his little Bhagavatam. Then after that, he starts expanding. Any teacher does that, you ask a question, first he will give you a brief answer. Then the student says, oh, awesome, that was something. Then he expands. That's what happens. So if you can catch his first few words, if you get, now he's explaining how the people are. Nidraya hiyatenaktam. Devāyena ca vāmanaha Divācāte hayārājan Uttam avaranena namā. Yeah, who will chant this?
Nidraya
hriyate naktam Devāyena ca vāmanaha Divācātayārājan Kutumbhavarane Nama. Dikhni rahe na toh se. Woh chota hai kya? Other people can see? Now this is very very, now he is giving why they have thousands of things to hear. He is explaining more. General view. Nidraya hriyate naktam. Raat ko kya karte ho? Ya toh Naktam means night. Diva means day. He is telling what they do in the day, what they do in the night. Naktam, yada sote. Vivayena, or they have sex. That's the night time of a household. Correct? And diva jartaya raja, in daytime, artha. They're looking for money, sweeter than honey. More than pasapatana, kaise pasapatana. And kutumbu bharane nama. पैसे से क्या करते हैं? एक फ्रिज ले लिया, एक एसी ले लिया, घर को भरो सामान से. He is saying a blind materialist कि जिंदगी में और कुछ नहीं. दिन भर पैसे कमाओ और सामान लाओ और रात को सो जाओ या सेल करो. Therefore he says they have no interest in ātma-tattva. Deha pratya karatra ishu. Ātasaineshu asatsu api. Desham Pramatanidham.
Vashyana
Vina Parishati.
Long
bracket eggs. Agaman. Not secure protection. They, because they themselves are fallible. And now he's concluding, that is, this is conclusion. Tasmat, he says, therefore, Tasmat is therefore, based on the previous four shlokas, Bharata Sarvatma, who is Sarvatma? We are present only in my body, that is my power. Jiva is an ātma, which is present in this body. Therefore, this body is conscious. You are aware today, you are sitting in a class. Correct? That is because of ātma. So he says, but Sarva ātma is only God. Not only is present in your body, he is present in everybody's body, including an ant's body. He is aware of everything that is going on to the life of that ant. So that is O Bhagavan. Another word for that is Ishvara, Supreme Controller. Another word is Hari. So now it's very specific, referring to the Supreme Personality of God and Krishna. Shrotavya Kirtita Vyascha. So now, Aram says, please hear about it. Shrotavya means to hear. Kirtitavya means when you hear, then you will talk. You don't hear what you talk about, correct? Generally, any part of the world, Srila Prabhupada used to go. Every religion actually, all religions are good. But there is not much talk about the Lord. God is great, He is merciful. First of all, talk no. How does He work? What is He doing? What does He do with His pastime? Talk no. But generally, it is not everything. And that is a special privilege of believers. Prabhupada was very much against people saying India West, all this thing. Prabhupada never liked that. But he was always upholding the unique, special privilege of the Vedic literature. There is so much glory to the Lord of fact. But we have to keep some time and hear. So Shrotavya, Shravan means to hear. Just like a lot of people have chosen, let us go and hear about Krishna. Okay? This is Shrotavya. When you hear, then you talk. Because what we talk depends on what is inside of your word. We fill our mind with so many thoughts about Krishna. Somebody comes to talk. Shrotavya Kirtita Vyascha. And when you hear and you talk, then you start thinking of Smartavya. Okay? Who should do that? Chaichata Abhayam, who wants to be fearless. Anybody who wants to be fearless, this is the way. All of us are fearful in the middle of existence. Even the Karnataka chief minister doesn't know whether he is going to survive tomorrow. You know, those who know the politics. You know. Even Mangoy doesn't know whether he will survive. Everybody is in fearful condition. Correct? Sonia Gandhi is in not, she knows the fear. Kya hoga? Rahul Gandhi, everybody is in danger in this world. Everybody. And any time she also had some health problem, secretly she is going, nobody knows what she got. Maybe cancer or some problem. Everybody is fearful in this world. But if you want to achieve the stage of fearlessness, true? If you want to be fearless, what you should do? Just hear about the Lord. Glorify him. Think about it. Therefore, Sukadeva Gosvāmī is saying that this is my recommendation. You can don't hear all so much kachara subject matter. You hear about the Lord. And if you just do this, your life will be successful. This is what he is doing. Then he said, Etavān Sāṅga Yogyā. Etavān Sāṅga Yogyā. Etavān
Sāṅga Yogyā.
Swadharmā Parinishnaya.
Swadharmā Parinishnaya.
Janmalāvaha Parāpumsāṁ. Because we all know that is the highest perfection. That's why kya nothing even martha Rama Nama Satya bolte na. Taki somehow that person should be able to remember the Lord. But Rama Nama is always Satya, not only at that time. Whole life should be Satya. And so Ante Narayana Smriti will not happen accidentally. We have to cultivate our meditation of the Lord and our devotion should keep increasing. Not that we become complacent. It should come to the stage of perfection. Like Sukadeva Gosvāmī, and then not only we can benefit ourselves, we can benefit them.